it's a. I think I've talked about this in the last live stream, which is explain the full Fruity Multiband Compressor. So we talked about compression a lot, and I've talked about compression a lot, and it's one of the most elusive concepts to get in music production. It's not really easy to get compression, and it takes a while. But after a little bit, after reading, I want to say reading a lot, but after understanding, watching some of tutorials and practicing mixing and mostly mixing and mastering, you will start to get a better understanding of compression. So let's go into multiband compression and see what it's all about. So let's go here. We have a dynamic section and Fruity multiband compressor. So basically, a compressor, a normal compressor, if we go here and go to this basic compressor, what we usually have is, let me take this off just so that we don't have too much distractions. What we do usually have is we have a compression, a compressor will have a threshold, a ratio, a gain, an attack release, and a type of compression. And in this case, the type might not be there, but you will most likely have a threshold, a ratio, an attack and release, and a gain. So these are the five most common parameters in a compressor. You might find some more, and you might find some that you don't have. For instance, you might not have a direct button for attack and release, and you might not have a ratio, for instance, in the LA, not LA, in the CA2A, for instance. We don't have a ratio here. As you can see, we have a gain knob and a peak reduction knob. So this is kind of like the amount that we feed into the compressor, and here would be the reduction that we have. So, and then we have here some other options. So there are different types of compressors, but in the most general case, you will find a threshold, a ratio, an output gain, attack and release. And if we go into the multiband compressor, we have basically three bands of our three of the same compressors spread out in bands through the audio spectrum. So if we look at the compression for low band, or the compressor for low band, we have threshold, ratio, attack, release and gain. We also have here the knee. And I will not touch the knee, but if you think about compression, we will have a threshold, ratio, attack, release, and gain. And if we look at the low band, mid band, and high band, we have pretty much the same knobs. Then we have these buttons here, which is the low band state is on. We can have it muted or we can have it bypassed. So let's say that we want to have that we just want to compress the higher frequencies. What we will do is bypass both mid and lows and just compress the highs. And we can do the opposite. We can just compress the mids and highs and just compress the lows. So we can, with these buttons here, we can pretty much compress whatever we want. We can also mute a specific band. So we have now plugins to do that. We have the plugin that I talked about, which is the splitter. Let's go here. Let me find the splitter. Frequency splitter. This is the new plugin that I talked about in the beginning of the live stream. And you can see that we have three bands. And this basically splits the frequency range that we have from 20 to 22K. I think that should be 22 or 20K here. What we have is three bands. And basically what we have here, if we look into the multiband compressor here, is that we have low band, mid band, and high band. And if we look at here at the division of the bands, you will see that it's very similar to the division here that we have in the splitter. So I think the splitter is basically just an extraction of this algorithm that we have here, or the crossovers that we have here, both on the multiband compressor and also on Maximus. But yeah, then we have, so we can set we will have a compression just for a specific band, or a compressor just for a specific band. So let's say that we want to mute everything and just add compressor and listen to only the mid frequencies. We would mute the low and high and just apply compressor to the mid band. And we can also have a splitter with this plugin. So let's say that we just want to listen to the mid band, we would bypass the compressor and mute all the high and low bands and just get the mid band. So this is a really cool way for us to manipulate in different ways, or have a splitter also with a multiband compressor. But that's not the point. I was just wanted to give you an idea of the buttons here at the top. And then we have here, so this tells us where the crossover will happen. So this will give us the frequency at which the low band compressor will actuate. So, or the range, it will go from 20 to, and if we look here at the hint panel, it will go from 22 to 57 hertz. And the same goes for here, for the mid band, it will go from 300 to 9.9K. And the high band will go from 9.2K up to 20K. So this is what we can do. And let's go ahead and bring a loop just for the sake of listening to some compression here so that you can see what I was talking about. Let's bring a generic FL Studio loop. Let's bring the speed down. Okay, so now let me go here, bring the volume also a little bit down so that this doesn't blast our ears. I think the volume is okay. Let's unmute all the other plugins so that there's no effect here. And now if I hit play and start messing around here with the buttons, you see now I only have the compressor for the high band, and I could bypass the compressor or mute everything. And let's do A, which is on. And let's do the same thing here for the mid band. So this is the mid band, and we could do also for the low band. So this could work also as a splitter. But let's go now and see what are these parameters here. As you can see, we have here input. If we right click, if we left click, it shows us the output. So this is helpful for us to see the input and output, and if we need to add some gain to match the input volume or decrease or increase. It depends on the case. But let's see. Let's take the ratio. Let's take the knee. Let's put the knee at 0%. Let's take all the compression from this, and let's bring this as the default so that there's no effect here in the frequencies. And let's mute the other ones. And if I do this, let's put a ratio of maybe 3:1. And then when we start decreasing the threshold, we start seeing some here. The C stands for compression, and this is how much compression we are seeing. Unfortunately, there's no way to visually see how much compression we get. So we have to go here, put the cursor over to the point there, and then look at the hint panel. This will tell us pretty much that at this point we have minus 7.8 dB of compression, more or less. So I would say that we have a lot of compression at this point. And we can see now the beginning. And let's put now the output. And the output is a little bit low, so we could add a little bit of gain. Okay, and we can see also here that the reddish line, it's probably the compressed line. So we can add a little bit of gain. And we have pretty much the same input and output. Let's go to this one. Let's mute that one. And we could do the same thing here. Just change the ratio. And let's put also a ratio like this. And we can also do a little bit of gain. And you can see pretty much the difference, what is happening from the beginning, from the input, which is that line, the purple line, and then the red line is the compressed line. So let's go now to the high band, and let's apply some compression. Let's change the ratio. And let's now take everything and let's see how does this sound. So this helps us to add compression to different bands of the spectrum. And this is really cool, and we can really change stuff here. We have also some presets that we can take a look and work with. And there's also this IIR or fear. This is infinite impulse response, and this is finite impulse response. So this determines what type of filters will be used for the crossovers here. And we can also add some limiter just to clip the output so that we don't get above 0 dB. So I think that's it for a brief introduction to multiband compressor, to the Fruity multiband compressor. Basically, this tells us here, it shows us the compression signal, the input and output. And then we have here the filters where we can change the crossover sections or frequencies. Then we can apply the normal compressor presets or knobs, settings, probably that's the best word. And we can change the settings here for every single band. We can enable, mute, and bypass the band or the compressor. And that will help us achieve the desired goal that we want or that we have when we want to apply multiband compressor. I think this is a really cool thing to learn and to try out, experiment. One of the ways I use multiband compressor is in my mixes. Every mix I have a multiband compressor or maybe two, and also in my mastering. In my mastering, I might have this one here, the multiband. When I'm mastering, I like to use the linear phase multiband stereo. This is a plugin from Waves, and I really like this plugin for mastering, because it gives us some linear phase, so it doesn't mess around with the phase, and that's very important in the mastering session. And as you can see, we have threshold, gain, range, attack, and release, the five, maybe not the range, but this would be maybe a ratio, but the five, or at least these four, threshold, gain, attack, and release, we can pretty much assume that we will have this type of parameters.